全く承認できないですね。もう心から反対します。
近来不少的专家学者都对日本福岛核污染水
早急にこう流していきたいということではなく、まずやはりアルプス処理水137万トンを1日あたり最大でも500トンしか流さないと。
If you ingest enough of it, it can do harm if you drink it. But the release at Fukushima is planned to be 1,500 becquerels per litre. And actually, the World Health Organization drinking water standard for tritium is 10,000 becquerels per litre. So in theory, you know, if it wasn't full of salt, then the diluted water that's being released from Fukushima could be drunk.
Provided what is discharged is small compared with what we're already experiencing, then it's difficult to see how it can have any big effect.
One of the fundamental problems is they don't know if they're going to be successful.In processing the water, which means we don't know what the final radioactive inventory will be of the water that's planned to be released. All of those radionuclides behave differently in the environment. They bioaccumulate at different levels.
Strontium can follow calcium into bones or into the shells of marine organisms, for example. The more strontium you supply, the more will go into those tissues.And it's back just down to the question of, is that amount that's going into the tissues small enough that it doesn't significantly increase risk?